Well, I tell you, I was really starting to feel good as I was coming up this serpentine road, picking up altitude as I went along out of Gibson, Colorado. I thought, oh, this is really, really going to be nice. I was expecting or hoping for easy, and this was easy. After all, I'm by myself. And notice how wide this road is. Seems like you could get two tractor trailers passing each other on this thing. And so I didn't have to worry about somebody flying around a corner and running head on into me. It was just easy. You know, the higher up I got, the better the views were. There you see Gibson, Colorado off in the distance there. Now, these guys, I have to say, made me a little bit nervous. I looked at them. I thought, you know, those are the kinds of things that they could just go blasting on these roads. But I thought, well, who cares? You know, it's plenty wide, plenty of room for both of us. No problem, right? Then came the fork in the road. My nice, wide, smooth road went off to the right, and I had to go to the left, and that's not quite as nice a road. This thing had a lot of ruts in it, and it continued to get a little bit more narrow as I went a little further. And it's known as Trail Gulch Road, and I think it's because this is a trail and that's a gulch. And we were right on the edge of that thing, and I thought, boy, if I wind up down there, I'm going to be food for jackals for a couple of weeks. But anyway, this is where I began to get nervous about somebody coming around a corner the other direction. So I tried to stay as far to the right as possible and kind of took it easy through here, especially with these ruts. There was a sign and warnings not to ride when it was wet, but somebody did because they dug some real deep ruts on this thing and occasionally it would hook a tire. But anyway, it just kept getting more and more beautiful and I was really enjoying it. I stopped at this location because in the background you can see there's an old abandoned cabin there and another outbuilding of some kind. It looked almost industrial. And just stopped to take a break and take a picture. And while I was there was a guy from New York who came by. His name was James, I believe. And he was on a GS BMW. And I was sort of having tire envy because he had serious knobby tires on it. He had been out for weeks riding by himself. And we sat there and exchanged stories and talked for a while. Asked him how things were up ahead. He said, this is probably the worst section of the whole trail, of the section that I was on. And I said, boy, if you can get this far, you should be fine. I wish he was right. Okay, let me show you where I'm at. It's a very isolated road. I'm only about 6 or 7 miles from Gypsum. I met another rider. His name was James. He's from New York. He's been all over the country the last couple of weeks. And he had just come through this section that I'm on right now and said, oh, it's really easy. It's no big deal. No deep sand or anything like that. You'll be fine. I've only got maybe 8 miles to go now before I'm off of this and on to the easier stuff. But he said, this is the worst part of it. And you know what? I agree because I went down. I went down about, 50 yards down this road here. And this stuff on the ground is just like liquid. There's no riding on it. And I was up on the pegs real high, and the front end went away, and I went off into this embankment. You see, it's got this embankment along the road here. And the bike fell over to the left and landed and pinned my left leg between the embankment and the bike and twisted my knee just a little bit. I felt a little bit of pain. So now I'm laying there and I'm pinned under the thing. I could not get my foot out between the embankment and the bike. So, and the sun was out. It's clouded over now, thank God. I'd like to get out of here before it rains because this would be a mess in the rain. But anyway, I was close enough to my equipment bag, which is right there behind me. And I unstrapped it, opened it up, and got out my Glock folding shovel and started digging underneath my leg. And it took about 30 minutes to dig a hole where I could finally slide my foot out. And that was a great joy. So far, I've been here almost an hour, and nobody has come along. Wound up having to strip everything off the bike again, and once again dig a hole underneath the rear tire and tip it up into the hole. And it came up pretty easily. So now I've spent the rest of the time carting all my stuff 50 yards up the, or 50 feet, whatever it is. Everything seems so big out here. Up the roadway where I parked the bike. So I'm going to take it real easy, stay low on the bike when I'm in this soft stuff, and see if I can finish at least this section of the trail. But I'm not so sure this is a great idea by yourself. If there was somebody else here, we would have picked the bike up right away and been out of here. But the last time I dropped the bike, I found a deep satisfaction in being able to get out of the situation I was in. Well, I think that comes later because I'm not really out of the situation yet because I still have another 10 miles or so to go. Anyway, maybe later the satisfaction will come. So anyway, I'll keep you updated. Give you a quick panoramic view here. Talk to you later.
Well, after that little piece of adventure, after getting pinned underneath the bike, I think I was under the bike for about 35, 40 minutes before I was able to get myself out from underneath it. I couldn't budge the thing. It was really wedged against that embankment. I had my right foot free and I kept shoving against the bike and I couldn't get it to move. And then I took off as much weight as I could possibly get off the bike. Anything I could reach, I took it off. and still couldn't move the thing. And that's when I got the bright idea to dig out my shovel and dig out my leg. So anyway, with that behind me, I can tell you the rest of the way, I took it easy. I was in no hurry, a little bit gun shy, I would say. But the road really was not that bad. It was just that one area that I came across where it wasn't sand. It was just very, very fine silt. And in the spot where I went down, it was 6 to 8 inches deep. And I pretty much lost the front end as soon as I came around the corner and went into the embankment. But my knee was starting to hurt pretty good by this time. Going down again really wasn't in the cards. I just wanted to get through this section and find a piece of paved road see if I couldn't figure out where to go from there. So anyway, you can see still dealing with the deep ruts, and occasionally I ran into some soft stuff, and instead of staying up on the pegs, I would get down and put my feet out like outriggers and kind of plow through it. But that seemed to work pretty well. It's not like I'm some poster for riding off-road, but hey, I had a good time, and once again, just get a load of that scenery. It was really cool out there. I came up a little more on some soft stuff here and kind of hit the brakes. You can see the dust overtaking me, but this was real soft through here, and just you can see the front end wiggling around a little bit there. But I was much better off being down on the seat than up on the pegs. So stay tuned for next time. See if I actually get out of this canyon.